The Pythagorean Theorem. Last time we asked the following question. If your character spawns on an infinitely large sheet of graph paper, then moves A boxes to the right and B boxes upwards, then how far is she from her starting point? We can picture her standing at the top of a ramp, A boxes long and B boxes high, with the bottom of the ramp right at her spawn point. In our flat video game universe, this ramp looks like a triangle. It's a right triangle, in fact, which means that one of its corners looks just like the corner of a square. We know the lengths of the two shorter sides, call them A and B, and we want to find the length of the longer, slantier side, call that C. To puzzle this out, we can use a trick available to mathematicians and game designers alike. We can make copies of the triangle, play with them, and see what happens. The triangle has a square corner, so we could try making four of these triangles, and then see if we can somehow put them together to make a square. This is a pretty nice square. We've made two squares, actually. There's a nice big square on the outside, and a smaller, slanty square hole in the middle. Let's just fill that hole in. What's the area of that smaller square? Well, its sides are the same length as the long side of the triangle. Remember, we decided to call that number C. So its area is C times C, or C squared. Of course, we don't know what C is yet, it's what we're trying to find out, but we can make statements about it anyway. This picture gives us another way of describing the smaller square, though. We can think of it as a piece of the larger square, a piece that you get by cutting off the four triangles. So the area of the small square must be equal to the area of the big square minus the total area of the triangles. What's the area of the big square? Well, its sides are length A plus B. So its area must be A plus B times A plus B. So let's see, that's A squared plus A times B plus B times A plus B squared. Let's simplify that a little bit. It's A squared plus 2AB plus B squared. Well, what about the area of the four triangles? Well, here's a sneaky trick you can do with right triangles. If you fit two copies together, you can get a rectangle with area A times B, or AB. In this case, we have four triangles, so we can make two rectangles with a total area of 2AB. So here's the equation we've found so far. C squared equals A squared plus 2AB plus B squared minus 2AB. 2AB minus 2AB is just zero, so we can drop that part. And here's what we have left. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. We've just shown that this rule is true for all right triangles. This is called the Pythagorean Theorem, and we can use it to find the distance between any two points on our infinite piece of graph paper. For example, if we start at the origin, move four boxes to the right, and then three boxes upwards, then how far are we from the starting point? Well, in this case, A is equal to 4, B is equal to 3, and C is the number we're trying to find. Since A squared plus B squared equals C squared, we know that C squared is equal to 4 times 4 plus 3 times 3. That's 16 plus 9. That's 25. So C squared is equal to 25. And that means C must be 5. And that's the answer. We've gone 5 units from the origin. What if you're not starting at the origin, though? What if you're trying to find the distance between two random points on the plane? Let's call them x1, y1, and x2, y2, perhaps. How can you use the Pythagorean Theorem to find that distance? See if you can figure it out. Next time we'll take this a step further and start measuring distances in three-dimensional space, and even in higher dimensions, too.